What the hell is that?
On today's show, strange statements.
So I think you've probably got some secret passages.
If anybody feels like having a go at exploring my secret passages, then they're welcome.
Raunchy revelations.
I haven't been in a boy's bedroom this young for about 2 weeks. 2 weeks, you lucky
woohoo! And weird websites.
Why are the hand dryers so low in the toilets?
It clearly shows there's a lot of marks around, which makes me want to emigrate.
As four rival hosts compete to win £1,000.
It's always nice to clap your eyes on a young man's exhaust, isn't it?
Worcester. Home to Barrow's Worcester Journal, a newspaper that's been published for over 300 years.
Now then, let's have a look at the paper today. Oh, good gracious, there's bare ankles on page 3.
And hoping to make front page news is our first host, country girl and estate agent, Vanessa Bradford.
Oh, hi, Mrs. Marshall, it's Vanessa.
Well, I like to look after myself. I mean, there's nothing worse than getting up in the morning and seeing widow twanky staring back at you.
Well, I know, we've all been there.
I think if I was able to describe myself in estate agent's terms, I would say that I've got a good approach, I've got a couple of good features, well-kept gardens.
Well, that's good to hear.
And I think that I'm always open to offers.
And open to offers from the recording industry is second contestant, wannabe rock star Aaron Jakes.
People's first impressions of me, they probably look at me and think, God, he's good-looking.
And he's so modest and humble with it.
My tactics, I'm going to play Mr. Nice Guy on my night, make sure everyone's happy. I know I'll win because I'll have the best food and entertainment.
I think Vanessa might have something to say about that.
With my menu, you'll be getting class and style. It's a twist on fine dining, but with a kind of country girl's attitude.
Vanessa is kicking off with a trio of starters. Chestnut and parsnip soup, country pate with homemade apple chutney and field mushroom on brioche.
If any one of those three falls short, it will spoil the overall impression.
Well observed from ex-mayor of Evesham, local councillor and third host, Mark Googe.
There's nothing cool about being dim. You need to make an effort to learn about the things that matter. I think I've generally been an outsider in most of the things I do. I find that I usually come to things with a different viewpoint to most people.
So need to get the old gloves on. Anyone need any inspections?
Oh, I think I'll pass on that. Vanessa begins her pate by frying onions and chicken liver in butter. A quick whiz, and finally it's dispatched into ramekins. So it's on to the main. Stuffed lamb with dauphinoise potatoes.
I'm totally excited. I mean it. It's like having a roast dinner on a Tuesday.
Ah, all your dreams come true. Meet our final host, golf club owner Angela Lever.
Oh! I do wear my heart on my sleeve, and I'm a very loud, bubbly person.
Crikey, let's hope your cooking's better than your swing.
I'd really like to think I can win. I don't know, I think I'd be devastated if I lose. I don't feel I'm a little bit down.
I've chosen a butcher that provides local sourced lamb. So it's a definite country lamb from probably round one of the farms by us.
Vanessa begins by filling her lamb with rosemary and porcini mushroom stuffing. Then she rolls.
That's probably going to be my least favourite of these courses, given that I'm not hugely a great fan of lamb.
Just rub my meat, give it a little massage. There you go, my darling.
Oh, yeah, now you got it. Oh, just down a little bit there. Left a bit. Ah, oh, lovely, that's a spot. One very relaxed and spoilt lamb finished off. It's on to dessert. Forest fruit and almond cobbler crumble.
That's what I'd order if I was at a restaurant and that was on the dessert menu.
The dessert isn't really my cup of tea. It's a bit old-fashioned, a bit boring.
To kick off her cobbler, Vanessa layers dried fruit, apple and orange zest.
This dessert will hopefully warm the hearts of my guests because it's nice and it's cosy and it reminds you of your nan.
You mean it sits in the corner drinking sherry?
Finally, Vanessa tops off her cobblers with a mix of self-raising flour, butter and sugar. Then she sprinkles with almonds.
I really feel I'm going to give my guests a real taste of the country. And all I need to do now is go and get myself glammed up.
Off you pop, then. First to arrive, it's straight-talking Angela.
Hi, how
Hello.
Are you? Come
Hiya.
On in,
Thank
come
you.
On in.
Thank you.
Lovely to meet you. I'm Vanessa.
Hi, Vanessa. I'm Angela.
Nice to meet you.
Call me Angie. Oh.
Hello, Angie. Oh, next up, local councillor Mark.
Pleased to meet you.
And last to rock up this evening, it's Aaron.
Hello. Hiya. How are you? I'm Vanessa.
I'm Aaron.
Can I get you a drink? Would you like some of my fizzy wizzy?
Oh, yes, pleasey wheezy. Coming up, dad dancing.
At one point, I thought he'd had a rhythmectomy.
Dodgy doppelgangers.
Who do you think that Mark looks like?
Boris Yoskin.
Boris Johnson.
Is that him? I know Boris Johnson's the mayor of London. I know that.
Can we have a look at it?
And tempting tats.
I really like him. Probably like him a little bit too much.
That tattoo trick works every time.
It's night one in and around Worcester, where estate agent Vanessa Bradford...
An amazing week. Cheers!
Here's hoping to corner the market with some country-style cooking.
I really want to make my starters really impressive so that they think, wow, is this the start of the beginning?
Or is this the beginning of the middle?
I can't touch anything without the gloves on, honestly.
Vanessa fries mushrooms in butter and creme fraiche for one-third of her trio of starters. And here they all are, chestnut and parsnip soup, country pâté and field mushroom on brioche.
This is delicious, Vanessa.
Oh, thank you.
I really like the soup.
Oh, good.
The soup was absolutely gorgeous. I'd have quite happily had just a proper bowl full of that soup.
I think she's done amazing to actually knock out three little starters. I would have just settled for the easier option and just done an amazing soup.
There's a lot more pâté there than I normally eat, so don't feel offended by the fact that I'm going to leave a fair amount of the pâté.
Oh, okay,
that doesn't indicate displeasure with it.
So that would indicate pleasure, then!
Can you cook for me tomorrow, please? I'll pay you.
Well, I think my starter went really well. The only thing I thought was I didn't quite have enough brioche for the pâté, but I think they really liked it.
At the table, talk turns to the most important woman in Aaron's life.
Are you a nanny's boy or a mummy's boy?
I'm probably a nanny's boy at heart, yeah. I've got a tattoo of her on my back.
No freaking way.
Yeah.
What, her face?
I hope it's her face.
Can we have a look at it?
Yeah, I might need a bit of help, though.
Angela?
Well, I have been a nursing assistant before.
He doesn't look like he needs any assistance.
Angela and Vanessa are both very forthright people. They say what they want and they're not afraid to say what they want.
And it looks like they've got what they want.
I think Aaron is adorable. He's really, really sweet. I really like him. Probably like him a little bit too much.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that's when she
was... a baby?
Yeah, well, when she was 4 years old.
Wow.
That's amazing.
That's actually quite endearing.
That's actually quite strange.
It certainly didn't take me long to get my kit off. I don't need much of an excuse. That tattoo trick works every time.
He seemed a little bit timid when he arrived, but he seems to be really warming up and he's lovely and he showed us his nana's tattoo. Not that I like it.
Maybe I've got a couple of little things. I'm not telling about it because I've got no intention of getting them out. Not a couple of things. That sounds awful.
Don't worry. In the kitchen, Vanessa's getting her meat and two veg out.
Winner, winner. Lamb dinner.
I admire your confidence, but we'll have to wait and see. Here it is, stuffed lamb with dauphinoise potatoes.
The potatoes are very well done as well.
Thank you.
They're easy to get wrong, and you haven't. Très bien for the dauphinoise.
Ah, merci beaucoup, Mac.
Thought I could have a little bit more meat. We had, like, maybe four, you know, like, little cuts of it.
I don't know why, but I've never hugely liked lamb that much. Mm-hmm. But... so I'm not really in a position to judge this one, but it's certainly edible. Sorry, that sounds like damning with faint praise. That's not what it's intended to be.
I think Mark's funny, yeah. I don't know if it's for the right reasons, but he definitely makes me laugh.
I think Mark is ultra-ly intelligent, which is why he can't function in this real world.
If I was to describe Angela in estate agent's terms as a house or a property, I would say that she's a really attractive, modern property. Because I don't necessarily think what you see from the front, from the curb, It's definitely what you're going to see inside.
How do I take that? What does that mean?
I think you're an unusual property. You probably haven't got a lot of what we say in the trade curb appeal, which is you're not, you know, maybe all that grand from the front. But I think in the back area, there's probably a lot more to you than meets the eye. So I think you've probably got some secret passages or some secret area.
I think that's very good. I really do. I think I would be quite happy to have that as a description of me in house terms.
I'm in a total mess.
You got a hanky for
it. Stop feeding Angela wine.
I have to check my face. I'm so sorry.
If anybody feels like it, having a go at exploring my secret passages, then they're welcome.
I think I'll pass on that extremely kind offer. Ah, here's dessert.
We've still got my little cobbler to go.
Cobblers to you and all. Are you on a boat? So here it is then, forest fruit and almond cobbler with a dollop of creme de pâtissière. Basically, it's custard.
The most exciting thing you've ever done?
I used to do stock car racing. I used to be a stock car racer.
You used to be a stock car racer?
Yeah. Just like, as a laugh, smashing into other people's cars all the time. And not having to worry about your insurance claim. It's amazing. It's absolutely amazing. You, Aaron, what's the craziest thing you've done?
Jumped out of a plane last year.
Parachute.
Obviously.
How high?
13,000 feet.
Nothing.
So what, you're just in the air for longer, or do you drop quicker being that high?
You don't drop any quicker, do you?
Actually, I think you'll find you do drop quicker due to science. Taxi!
The dessert was definitely the culinary highlight of the evening.
I think my food's gone down really well, and I think at the end of the day, I've got a good chance of winning.
Had a lovely time in the countryside, Vanessa. Therefore, she's getting a 7.
Nice!
For me, the food wasn't quite... It didn't quite hit the mark, so for me, it's a 6.
Food was up to expectations. Overall, it's a 7.
So, not quite the valuation she was expecting, but Vanessa has brokered a respectable 20 out of 30. Day 2 in Worcester, and wannabe rock and roll star Aaron Jakes is hoping to hit the top of the charts.
I think the other guests are going to look at me as the underdog. I don't think they're going to expect a fat lot from me. I mean, I'm a 24-year-old lad. They're probably going to be expecting beans on toast or something.
It's not your cooking the ladies are interested in.
I totally love Aaron. I love him. I could take him home. He could be, like, my new little puppy.
Aaron is the eye candy of the table. Obviously, we haven't got a lot to choose from. Sorry, Mark.
I think Mark thinks we're all a bit too loud. I think he'd prefer it if we was all sitting quite quietly doing a quiz. But I'm sure we're going to bring him round to our way of thinking.
Well, when I was 25 years old, I think I could just about... I could do curries, and that was about it.
Well, Aaron's 25, and guess what? He can do curries, 2 of them. A bit like a jalfrezi and a bit like a bona.
A bit like a buana. What? It is a buana, isn't it?
No, it's a boona.
Bahana.
What's a bahana?
I don't know. I don't read Indian.
It's written in English.
The theme for my night is just me. It's what I enjoy eating.
How very magnanimous of you. Aaron kicks off by frying garlic, pureed onions in ghee and tomato puree, swiftly followed by some tomatoes and chicken.
I think it could be a winner tonight.
A quick sprinkle of curry powder, a dribble of water and a handful of chilies topped off with coriander, and it's all left to simmer.
Looking good, baby.
Now that's a bit like a boona.
If it's a bit like one, how much is a bit? A lot, maybe. Maybe it's nothing like it. Maybe it's something completely different. Maybe it's actually a Madras and a Vindaloo and he's just keeping us guessing.
Maybe you're overthinking it.
Now time for the jalfrezi, the fiery one.
Using the same base curry as before, Aaron adds fried onions, peppers, and his own curry powder mix. And that's a bit like a jalfrezi.
Feeling very confident about tonight. Pull these off, brilliant. So hopefully we're on to a winner.
No, we're on to the starter. Another of Aaron's personal favourites, chili and lemon tuna fish cakes.
I hope he don't make it too hot. I know he likes spicy food. And I don't.
Brace yourself. That is a lot of chilies being added to boiled potatoes and spring onions.
I hope, for goodness sake, that Aaron has got fresh tuna.
Nope! He adds a squeeze of lemon, an egg, and gives the lot a good mash.
If I saw these chili and lemon fish cakes in an Indian restaurant, I'd definitely order them before my curry.
Not sure you'll find Thai fish cakes in an Indian restaurant. Aaron will be cooking these tonight. Next up, dessert. Irish cream profiteroles.
Is he going to make the profiteroles himself? Is he going to do the choux pastry?
The only ruddy is. Aaron starts his choux pastry by melting butter and sugar, lobs in some flour, adds an egg and folds.
Definitely starting to feel the pressure.
That's like the default choice in a restaurant when you're out there and there's nothing else on the menu that you like.
There's an art to pipe in. I'd say it's pretty much foolproof.
Well, it's either one or the other. After a quick blast in the oven and an injection of cream infused with a well-known Irish liqueur, dessert is done and dusted. Time to get ready.
All I've got to do now, go upstairs, get changed. This is going to blow their minds.
First up for a mind-blowing experience, it's Vanessa.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. And you?
All right.
Next in, it's Angela.
Very lovely.
Well. Thank you.
Help yourself to a strawberry daiquiri.
As you do. And finally, Mark.
Oh, looking very suave, eh, Mark?
I'm doing my best to posh up a little bit.
You should have tucked your shirt in.
Right then, here's to the rock and roll.
Rock and roll.
Rock and roll! So, to kick off tonight's show, our headliner is opening by frying his fish cakes.
These have been done a fair few times. They always go down a treat.
What treats will the girls find upstairs, I wonder?
Aaron's bedroom. I feel like I'm cheating on my husband being in here.
I know. I haven't been in a boy's bedroom this young for about 2 weeks.
2 weeks? Like, woohoo! You.
Steady on, girls.
What the hell
is that?
Oh my days.
That, I think that's Aaron without a beard.
That's not all he's missing.
Do you know what was nice about doing that, spending a bit of time with Vanessa? Yeah, I did like that. It was nice, us girlies coming away from the boys.
He's got rather
large... I hadn't even noticed that exhaust pipe.
It's always nice to clap your eyes on a young man's exhaust, isn't it?
Well, I'd rather clap my eyes on the starter, thank you.
Let's have it.
Indeed, let's have it. On a plate, then, please. Here we go. Chili and lemon tuna fish cakes.
It's obviously handmade.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can tell. That's what I'm saying.
It's got just the right kick from the chili.
Yeah.
Any more, it would have been overpowering. Any less, you wouldn't have noticed it.
So spot on, then.
He really did the business as far as the starter was concerned. That was absolutely delicious.
Did you use fresh tuna?
Yeah. No, it was tin tuna. You'd struggle to get that sort of flavour with fresh tuna. Because it's obviously been in the brine and stuff.
Yeah.
Brilliant, get our applause. It wouldn't be the same. Fresh real tuna from the sea.
Let me see. Fresh or tinned? It's always going to be the fresh one, isn't it?
Forget the tuna. Angie's getting fresh at the table.
It took us a while to identify which one was you. And then it's like your sweet and innocence is gone.
Vanessa, should that hand be there?
Have you seen this?
With the big exhaust.
Have you seen this?
I have now.
I'm really hoping...
I don't think I'll ever be able to unsee it.
I'm praying and hoping it was for charity and then you'll redeem yourself.
Last time I saw legs like that, they were hanging out of a nest.
Probably right, yeah. Are you going to get your exhaust out tonight, Mark?
I don't know.
I've enjoyed my starter. I certainly don't want Mark getting anything out while I'm sitting next to him.
I think Mark is definitely coming out of his shell bit by bit, and I think by Friday we could see a whole new person.
Well, I think Angela already has.
Are you real English? Like, British as, you know, like, white British? Are you Swedish or something?
To the best of my knowledge. I looked up my grandparents and stuff in 1871 census or something, things like that, to see what they were doing at the time and what their jobs were.
What area did they live in?
At that time, they were all living over in the Fens in East Anglia. I'm the black sheep that's travelled away from
you
home.
You were the one.
When Mark said that he was the black sheep of his family, I thought to myself, the rest of the sheep are clearly in a coma.
I really did think that someone in his family had European genes, but no, he's from... East Anglia. Now, is that Norfolk? Because I've been to Norfolk. That is, yeah. That was a dreary place.
Loads of clean plates. What more can you ask for? Let's just hope they're ready for the main. I'll be honest with you, my main course, it couldn't be looking any better than that.
Really? Two curries, one a bit like a Jalfrezi and the other a bit like a Booner.
But then, everybody, tuck in. I hope you all enjoy.
A bit disappointed you haven't done a naan bread.
Thing is, Mark, making a proper naan bread with your normal oven is next to impossible.
I'd have put up with one from the supermarket.
Would you? See, I was thinking I would have got marked down if I'd put...
Got marked down for the tuna in a can? No.
I've never had any of them curries. I normally would have a korma or a tikka masala. Oh, I like a shishlak. I don't mind that.
No pickles, no poppadoms, no naan bread. Maybe just a little bit of a disappointment.
I think the main course went down a treat. Ladies loved it. I think Mark was a bit disappointed he never had naan bread.
When we go out, if we see someone, we try to liken them to someone famous. So who do you think that Mark looks like?
Boris Yoskin.
Boris Johnson?
Is that him? I know what I mean.
Boris Johnson!
Who's Boris Johnson?
Not him!
Not Mark!
I think you did mean Boris Yeltsin, didn't you?
I don't think she knows who she means.
I don't know if I meant Boris Yeltsin or Boris Johnson. I know Boris Johnson's the Mayor of London. I know that.
Well done.
I'd rather be Boris Johnson. I suspect I look more like Boris Yeltsin.
When I first met my ex-husband, he showed his brother a picture of me, and his brother went, Jesus, are you dating Carol Vorderman?
Oh, my God, it is. You are so her.
Carol Vorderman.
Yeah, no, that's
great. She's about 76.
Yeah, but she's looking cracking.
She looks lovely.
She's fit for it, though.
Yeah, she's... Oh, hello.
Okay.
You hello, Mark.
Hello, Mark. Thinking man's totty.
And Carol, you like your quizzes? She must be your ideal woman.
Yeah.
I think Mark is enjoying himself more tonight than what he did yesterday. I think he's having an absolute ball.
I think we're starting to gel as a group. We're becoming kind of a team, really.
Time for more gelling!
1, 2, 3!
Angela was doing her best to get me to twist and shout and boogie on down.
At one point, I thought he'd had a rhythmectomy, but I do think that he's just maybe got dodgy hips.
I think he thinks, what are these crazy women going to do to me next?
I'm not really a dancer. My dancing days are well behind me now.
That's probably a good thing.
Like, to be honest, my night so far has gone absolutely perfecto. Magnifico. Bay Murray.
Other foreign words are available. Time for pud. Irish cream profiteroles.
You made them before?
I've not done them a lot of times, though.
Why are you so... Seriously, you're very white as a person. No. Your cheeks are really white. You're almost transparent.
You're making me think I'm ill.
No, that's why you look like a baby's bum, your cheeks. And that's why I thought you come from a European country. I think you work indoors all the time. I don't think you're an outdoors person at all.
That's probably fair enough. I spend most of my working life indoors, yeah.
You need to get out more.
And you can start by leaving right now. Taxi!
As a standalone dessert, that was excellent. Really well made. Really enjoyed it.
I really liked Aaron's dessert. I was so impressed that he made them himself.
It's higher than a 6. It's lower than an 8. It's a 7.
I've had a chance to twist and shout and get a bit of a boogie down with the ladies and the gents. And for all of that, I'm scoring Aaron a 7.
You're getting a twist and shout 8.
So, Aaron's knocked Vanessa off top spot and goes straight in at number 1 with a score of 22.
Oh, my thing.
Coming up...
I've been so disrespectful to the mayor.
Party politics!
How long do you sit in Congress with a mayor?
In Congress?
that's like a political thing, isn't it?
In America, yes.
Misplaced manners!
Your Highness, thank you for the seat.
You don't need to curtsy, and you don't call me Your Highness.
And excitement! It's day 3 in and around Worcester, and tonight's host, ex-mayor and local councillor Mark Googe, is drawing on all his experience as a political animal.
being a local politician and having been mayor for a year, you've got to have a thick skin to do that kind of a job. So I think that will stand me in good stead if people start getting critical of my cooking.
I am absolutely intrigued to find out where he lives, what he does, who he is.
I think it's probably the first time he's been out the house in years, but I think it's good for him to interact with normal people.
Well, mostly normal.
I think Mark's been struck by lightning at some point because he's got that white streak of band around the back of his head and the top of his hair is quite dark. That's very difficult to actually grow naturally unless someone's intervened, like God.
My menu theme for this evening is a traditional, old-fashioned English country meal.
Well, it's traditional to start with the starter. Fennel and celeriac soup.
Soup. It's predictable. Not really too excited about that.
It's an older person's soup. So, I'd expect that off Mark.
Cheeky. Having boiled celeriac, fennel, onions and garlic in vegetable stock, Mark's soup gets a whiz in the blender.
I'm using coarse ground black pepper, even though that will leave black specks in it, because I think it's just a bit more rustic than using finely ground pepper. It'll add a little bit of colour to it.
One soup seasoned. Time to move on to the main. Oldie English spiced beef with rustic roast winter vegetables.
I don't know what's old about it. Is the beef gone off?
What's it spiced with?
Let's find out, shall we?
The original idea for this recipe came from my mum, who's cooked this a few times when we've had special occasions. I've taken it and adapted it, basically to use what I've got in the cupboard rather than needing to go out and buy things specially.
This is a competition. After a good root around in the cupboards, Mark's found cumin and mustard seeds, black pepper, cloves, allspice and juniper berries.
Sometimes when I've had a bad week at work, something like this can be a good way of relieving the stress.
Mark then mixes molasses with water and dumps in his concoction of spices.
It's basically a tarted up roast dinner, isn't it, really? It's what I expected, meat and two veg.
Finally, he covers his beef and leaves to marinate. Time for some pud, I think. Apple and blackberry fool!
Boring again. I say, I'm in for a right treat tonight.
Oh, cheer up, Mr. Miserable. Mark kicks off by heating apples and sugar.
I don't think I've ever come across anybody who doesn't like apples, so I'm hoping this is a pretty safe choice for dessert.
No, don't rock my boat, that don't.
He slings in some blackberries, reduces and leaves to cool whilst pondering the meaning of life.
Egg came first because if everything evolved from a single-cell organism...
Yes.
Into various other things. At some point, a bird that was not a chicken...
Right.
..laid an egg that contained a chicken.
The chicken inside it.
The egg came before the chicken.
It came first! I didn't follow that at all.
Simple.
Maybe to you. Mysteries of the universe solved, Mark can crack on, folding egg whites and yoghurt into cream. Next, he dumps in his fruit mixture and chucks the whole lot into glasses.
That's right. That works for me.
Glad to hear it. Fools in the fridge. Time to get ready.
I'm looking forward to being able to bore the pants off them on local politics if I get half a chance. I think some of the things we might talk about might shock them, surprise them, or make them think, what on earth am I doing here?
Yeah, I think it's probably going to be that one, isn't it? First to arrive at Mark's mayoral mansion.
Good evening.
Angela. Next to tonight's polling booth, Vanessa. Last at the door, Aaron.
Come in.
Hello,
how
Mark.
Are you? Welcome, everyone, to my humble abode. Let's have a toast to a really successful evening.
Excellent. Well said, Mark.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Cheers. Chin chin.
Whilst Mark checks on his starter, his guests are having a snoop around.
What the hell is all of this?
He's a mayor. I've been so disrespectful to the mayor of Evesham.
Every time walks in the room, stand up and curtsy.
And we'll curtsy and you bow.
He'll love that.
Okay.
Is this like royalty? It's not royalty.
Oh, Christ, Ange.
No, Ange.
But he does loads for the community. What a wonderful man.
All right, he's not Bob Geldof.
How long do you sit in Congress with a mayor?
In Congress?
that's like a political thing, isn't it?
In America, yeah.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, there's too many movies.
Right then, how about some starters?
I'm happy, this is looking very good.
Jolly good, your Madge. After a little spot of cream, it's ready to go. Fennel and celeriac soup and some tiny herbs.
Feel free to grab a bread roll if you want some bread to go with your soup.
I love the soup, Mark. I think the flavour's really nice. The black peppers, though, being whole, That nearly made my eyes water.
Sorry about the peppercorns. They're supposed to be ground. It came out of this.
Massive, massive peppercorns, which one got me by surprise. I thought I'd done well not to either choke or cry. I'm a bit concerned about what my number twos are going to be like tomorrow.
Peppery.
I thought I'd put in coarsely ground black pepper, not whole peppercorns, so I'm going to have to check that peppercorn grinder again, I think.
Well, that's Sunday taken care of.
You've just been upstairs and we've seen a painting of you in full mayor regalia.
Yeah, good, innit?
How long were you mayor for?
I was mayor of Evesham for a year, last year.
Do we need to curtsy to you from now on and call you Your Highness?
Oh, we forgot.
Yes,
no, I did actually curtsy to you.
Yeah, so, Your Highness, thank you for the soup.
You don't need to curtsy and you don't call me Your Highness.
Okay.
When I was mayor, the correct technical form of address was Your Worship.
And you have a ball at the end of your term, ship.
I didn't actually have a mayor's ball this year because we'd done quite a lot of other things and kind of around the end of the civic year, it's just balls all over the place.
Sorry?
From Evesham Council's point of view, I can only imagine it might have been a very tedious year for them.
It does make me feel proud. I mean, I really enjoyed being mayor for the year and it's great that people know about it. And I see it as part of my mission to explain local politics to people.
Well, next on your agenda should be your main course.
It's intended to be rustic cut as well, not thin sliced.
In that case, you've cracked it, sir. Mark plates his spuds and some roast winter veg. And here's the main. One very rustic cut of oldie English spiced beef.
With your beef, I can't taste the chilli very strongly. Again, though, is that because you didn't want to...
It's not chilli spice. It said Old English spiced beef.
Spiced beef.
That doesn't mean chilli
beef.
No,
you're right.
It means kind of like...
So what were the spices?
It's got...
Yeah, what were they?
It's got mustard, clove, allspice, juniper berries and cumin seed.
Well, honestly, I can't taste any of that.
No.
But I can taste the beef.
Well, that was a waste of time then, wasn't it?
Do you think it might take a long time for that beef to go through my system?
Well, at least it'll be well seasoned.
It's nice flavour, just a little bit tough. That's more appetising than that beef. May as well give that a good chew.
I got two clean plates out of four, which isn't bad, although having said that, one of them was mine, so...
I want to find out a lot more about you. Tell me everything and don't hold back.
We could be here all night.
Shorten it then.
Well, tell you what, have you ever been to a motorway service station?
Yeah.
Then you're one of the people who might be interested in my website.
It's a
website where people can leave reviews and ratings of motorway service stations.
Yep, you heard him, motorway service stations.
Why are the hand dryers so low in the toilets? Must be great for children, but very annoying for anyone over 1.5 metres in height. The car parking situation today was diabolical. We have just waited half an hour in a queue to get out.
What kind of people have got the energy and the time to write in and say, it took me 5 minutes to see the car park?
It clearly shows there's a lot of marks around, which makes me want to emigrate.
This has definitely been one of the strangest evenings of my life.
Don't worry, it's nearly over. Here's dessert. Apple and blackberry fool.
No, absolutely delicious. Look. Go on. Nice and light.
I don't need dessert.
So what would be your alternative? Another glass of wine? Cheese.
Got some cheese dippers.
Yeah.
Do you want a cheese dipper for dessert?
Now there's an offer. Or you could have a taxi.
Dessert was the best course of the night, for sure.
I would liken the dessert to be a bit like wallpaper paste with bits in.
If I was describing my night as a political party broadcast, this would probably be won by the raving loony party.
For me, Mark, it's going to be a 5.
Mark, I'm really sorry to say that I'd rather have a meal at one of your service stations that you recommend on your website than have your beef ever again. So for that reason, I'm going to give you a 5.
Food wasn't up to scratch, Mark, but you're no fool. 6.
With all the votes cast, it's not a landslide victory as Mark is bottom of the poll with 16.
It's the final day of the competition in and around Worcester, and our last host, golf club owner Angela Leader, is bringing a taste of her home country to her table.
I am half Maltese, so I'm literally feeding them me. I'm feeding them myself. They're going to be eating Angie tonight.
Well, not literally, I hope.
Is that cannibalism?
I do believe it is.
If Angela's cooking is in line with her personality, it's going to be a real experience tonight.
Oh, I think Angie's nuts. I don't know what to expect. It could be anything. Anything crazy.
I'm not sure what's in store at Angela's tonight. What my main concern is the fact that she did actually eat Mark's cooking last night, which makes me terrified that she knows nothing about food.
Don't fret. Angie has it all under control. She's kicking off with a Maltese classic. Rabbit in garlic and red wine with baked potatoes.
As Chaz and Dave say, Angela does love a bit of a rabbit, so I think there may be a bit of a subconscious hint of her personality in this menu choice.
Thank you, Sigmund Freud.
I've never tried rabbit. Really want to try it. She's really, really pushed the boat out for this one. That is going to be nice.
Angela kicks off by frying her bunnies in garlic.
I can't eat rabbit. I absolutely love them. You want me to eat one of those? No way. Not on your Nelly.
Tough crowd. Angela mixes mulled wine, bay leaves and seasons.
Run, rabbit, run.
Angela's rabbits will marinate until being cooked tonight, so it's on to the starter. King prawns in chili, garlic and ginger with traditional Maltese bread.
That sounds stunning.
That starter is right up my strata.
Angela kicks off with some garlic and grated ginger.
Oh, I could rub that all over my body. That's lovely.
I'm really looking forward to that. In fact, I'm hungry now just reading that.
Next into the mix are chilies and a splash of oil. Angela will cook her starter when her guests arrive. Are you sure there's enough? Oh, well, fair enough. Last but by no means least, dessert. Maltese mousse.
Is she clearly Maltese? Is she a Malteser and we didn't know? Is Angela a Malteser?
She certainly is.
But of course, we have absolutely no idea what's in a Maltese mousse.
I could hazard a guess.
My niece, Franny Annie, taught me this trick. Come on. Just one for me. I've done it! Look!
Well done, Franny Annie. You're a genius. Angie adds the egg yolk to melted chocolate, combines with the egg white, then adds a honeycomb-scented confectionery.
Oh, I think that'd be a pleasant surprise at the bottom.
Who doesn't like a pleasant surprise at the bottom? One Maltese mousse dispatched to chill.
Feeling really confident about tonight. Can't wait for my guests to come. One last thing to do, zhuzhing myself up. But Angie likes to say, Malteser myself up.
Coming up, rabbit rage.
I can't eat it. Oh, no. She won't eat the rabbit. Might have a bunny. Might have a pet. Please.
Maltese madness.
Should we have a reunion in Malta?
In Malta. Vanessa, Malta's not big enough for you.
Apparently, Malta is definitely not big enough for me. I mean, how rude.
And somebody wins £1,000.
In third place.
It's the final night of the competition in and around Worcester, and tonight's host, Angela Lever, is having a little trouble containing herself.
I'm feeling, like, proper. I've got to sort myself out, cos inside, it's like a volcano. I think I'm going to bleed and erupt.
I wouldn't do that. Here's your first guest.
Vanessa! Hello, my darling! Darling.
Next in, Mark.
Have a little bit of fruity Kirk Royale, sir.
As in Captain James T, presumably. And last over the threshold...
You're
right.
Hello.
Mwah.
It's party night, it's Angie's night. Cheers.
Cheers, Mark.
That's how I feel inside. I feel like doing the Running Man.
How about just doing your starter?
I think I should have had smaller bowls.
Yes, or bigger prawns. Here it is. King prawns in chili, garlic and ginger with a leaf.
So, this is a proper traditional Maltese bread. I've had it flown in from Malta.
Have you really had that flown in?
Yeah,
specially?
Of course I have.
Do you know it's flown?
Well, because how else would it get here?
Well, it might have come by truck.
No, it takes too long.
I thought the starter was absolutely brilliant. I'm not normally a prawn eater, but they were absolutely perfect.
A bit disappointed that the bread weren't homemade.
It was flown in from Malta, you know.
It doesn't matter if it was flown in from Malta. I could have got my curry flown in from India.
All right, now you're just being pedantic.
I thought the starters went down really well. Unfortunately, I don't think there was enough there. Initially, in my head, I thought they'd all have five each, and then I upped it to eight, thinking I was being really generous. I should have upped it to 80.
You speak Maltese?
I can just about speak English, Vanessa. But what I do know Maltese is, I love you, my darling. Can I have some money?
Can we have I love you, my darling?
In Hobbok Albi. And this is how you'd ask for money. Tini flus oki ojbok, which is, can I have some money, please?
Tini flus oki ojbok.
Mark, that's amazing. How can you do that? So I've just said that once and you've picked it up straight away.
Should we have a reunion in Malta?
In Malta. Vanessa, Malta's not big enough for you. Yeah, you'd get bored very quickly, I think.
I don't think I would.
Apparently Malta is definitely not big enough for me. I mean, how rude.
At least you've got the Maltese main to look forward to.
Rabbit is a bit weird, it is a bit different, but I think they're all up for it.
Well, we'll soon find out. Here it is. Rabbit in garlic and red wine with baked potatoes. It's not looking promising.
What's the matter?
I can't eat it.
It's all right, it's fine.
I'm so sorry.
No, it's not a problem. I knew it was a bit of a long shot. It's fine.
It's pets.
Well, that's what we used to do, eat our own pets.
You've eaten your own pets?
Yeah. In Malta, you don't buy a rabbit that you haven't seen alive and kill it and skin it yourself because it could be anything. So all my aunties and uncles rear their own. You go in the backyard and you pick your rabbit for the night.
Is that any different to slaughtering your own lamb?
Good point, Mark. Yeah,
no, of course it's no different. But I've never had a pet lamb, so...
I'm genuinely surprised that Vanessa had a problem with eating rabbit because of seeing them as pets. I'd had her down as somebody who'd have the same kind of robust attitude to animals as I do.
We're in Worcester. I don't eat rabbits. There's a lot of myxomatosis out where we are. I'm slightly concerned about getting that glazy eye thing going on.
I really enjoyed the main course. I thought that the whole idea was great. The rabbit tasted delicious.
Oh, no. She won't eat the rabbit. Might have a bunny. Might have a pet. Please.
If she won't eat a rabbit, she might eat a moose. A Maltese moose. Oh, and a strawberry.
So what makes this Maltese moose?
Have you got to the bottom yet?
Has it got a Malteser in the bottom?
There's Maltesers crushed at the bottom.
So it's not a traditional Maltese recipe?
Not at all. The Maltese dessert is almonds and nuts and pastries, and I hate all of that. So this is my own little twist on it.
The dessert, again, was wonderful. I really, really enjoyed the dessert.
To be honest, the mousse had set, I think, so it was more... It was all quite hard. It was a bit like a brownie.
This drink here is called Kinney. Once again, it's another Maltese Kinney product. It's only produced and sold in Malta. It's non-alcoholic. I mean, will you be all right with that? Is it going to poison you, Vanessa?
I don't know. I'll probably have to cope with that.
It's a very unique taste.
Cheers.
Cheers. Oh, cheers. Once again, another very unique taste, this.
Cheers.
And thank you for a lovely, lovely evening, Angela.
Thank you very much.
Yes, lovely, lovely. Let's hear the scores, please.
Angela, I've learnt that tonight you are not afraid to take risks. You're prepared to be absolutely who you are. And when you do that, you do it really well. So for that, I'm giving you a 9.
Tonight, Ange, I'm scoring you a 6.
So, Angela will need at least an 8 to take top spot.
I've loved hanging out with you this week. You are my absolute new bezzy mate, and for that reason...
Hold on a minute! It's up to our host to reveal the final scores.
Here we go! Fourth place, Mark.
Come on, Mark!
In third place, beautiful Vanessa.
Come on, Vanessa! Lovely.
No freaking way! Join place, Angie and Aaron! It's AA!
We won it!
Vanessa scored Angela a 7, leaving her on top with Aaron. And as you can see, she's quite pleased.
I've really enjoyed myself this week. It's been absolutely great fun. I've made some great friends, and I'm going to remember this for the rest of my life.
Wise words, Your Worship.
That, I have to say, is one of the weirdest, strangest weeks of my life.
I am buzzing. Come on, let's have it.
And if you'd like to celebrate by running around your living room, please go to the Channel 4 website.
That's it. I won it. amazing. Came first joint with Aaron. Oh, I'm so happy. I've done it. I won it. Met some very nice people, but I won it. I love it. So pleased. Can you tell I'm pleased? I'm very pleased.
Now, I'm no expert, but I think she's pleased. A new series sees Jamie Oliver travelling the world in search of healthier lives. Jamie's Superfood this Monday night at 8. Next today, accidents will happen. The Simpsons pay the price for dodgy driving.